What if I told you that tiny fragments of ivory, lost for nearly 500,000 years, could completely rewrite the story of human ingenuity? Forget just stone tools. Deep in Ukraine, at a site called Medzhiboz A, archaeologists uncovered something extraordinary. 24 pieces of mammoth tusk. Not just any mammoth tusk, mind you. These date back roughly 400,000 years. Now, 400,000 years ago puts us in a warm period, an interglacial. Steppe mammoths roamed this part of western Ukraine. We found their remains there. And someone, likely our ancestor Homo heidelbergensis, wasn't just hunting them. They were looking closely at those massive tusks. Because here's the kicker. 11 of these tusk fragments show clear signs of being deliberately worked. We're talking potential cut marks, flake scars, evidence that someone intentionally shaped this ancient ivory. 6 pieces even look like they were napped. Yes, napped, like stone tools. They were striking the ivory precisely to chip off flakes, maybe trying to shape it, create an edge. But hold on, napping ivory? That's weird. Ivory dentin is way softer than flint, much more brittle. Think trying to sculpt with chalk versus granite. It's difficult, it breaks easily, it won't hold a sharp edge like stone. So why bother? Why apply stoneworking techniques to this challenging material? This is where it gets really mind-bending. The previous, widely accepted oldest evidence for working ivory was maybe 120,000 years ago, often linked to Neanderthals. Widespread use, things like beads and figurines, that's even later, maybe 50,000 years ago. This discovery, 400,000 years old, it potentially pushes the timeline back by an incredible 300,000 years. It predates the known Neanderthal evidence by almost 3 centuries. So who was doing this? The best candidate is Homo heidelbergensis. We haven't found their bones right with the ivory, which is common, but the timing and location fit. This suggests these early humans, often pictured wielding crude stone choppers, might have been far more experimental, far more curious about materials than we ever imagined. Why go through the trouble of working ivory if it wasn't great for sturdy tools? The researchers noticed something fascinating. The shapes of these tiny ivory pieces, just a few centimeters long, seem to mimic the shapes of stone tools found in the same layers. Little flakes, maybe even a tiny core. The block you strike flakes from. What could that possibly mean? One stunning hypothesis is that these weren't tools for heavy work at all. Could they have been practice pieces? Maybe even toys? Imagine using softer ivory to learn the complex motions of napping stone, without wasting precious flint or risking serious injury. Think about it. Evidence of teaching, of learning, maybe even playful experimentation. 400,000 years ago. It paints a much richer picture of their lives than just survival, doesn't it? And maybe this isn't so surprising when we look around. We're constantly finding hints that early hominins were more complex than we thought. Think of the ancient bone tools from Boxgrove in the UK, also linked to Homo heidelbergensis. Or that incredible 476,000-year-old wooden structure found in Zambia. Or even a potentially 500,000-year-old engraved shell from Java, possibly made by Homo erectus. The story of human evolution isn't a simple straight line. It's full of surprising turns and early sparks of innovation. Maybe we've overlooked evidence like this before, dismissing tiny worked fragments of bone or ivory as just natural damage. These Ukrainian finds were apparently spotted during lab analysis of animal bones, not the main tool hunt. What else might be hiding in museum drawers waiting for a second look? Of course, many questions remain. We need more work to confirm the dating and the human modifications. Experimental archaeology, trying to replicate these objects today, will be crucial. And the ultimate prize? Finding hominin fossils right alongside the ivory. Was this a unique local experiment at Medzhiboz, maybe driven by a scarcity of good flint? Or was ivory working more widespread much earlier than we thought? And what exactly were they used for? But what these tiny 400,000-year-old pieces of mammoth tusk undeniably do is challenge us. They force us to reconsider the capabilities, the curiosity, perhaps even the cognitive complexity of our distant ancestors like Homo heidelbergensis. They weren't just surviving, they were experimenting, learning, interacting with their world in ways we're only just beginning to grasp. These fragments are more than just artifacts. They're a tiny window into ancient minds, hinting at a past far more intricate and fascinating than we ever knew. And it makes you wonder, what other revolutionary secrets are still buried, waiting to rewrite history all over again?